Hello everyone. Hope you are all in the best of spirits, health and disposition. I am Sumaiya Lansari and welcome to a new video of Quest of Truth. On a special request from our friend Dr. Sanbeen Sheikh, today we are going to discuss the sixth lecture of the Principles and Practice of Homeopathy by Dr. Richard Hughes. That is to say, Similia Similibus. After talking about the sensations and phenomena of diseases and drug actions in the previous lectures, Dr. Richard Hughes now focuses on putting them together, that is the knowledge of disease and the knowledge of drug actions to attain cure. One thing that must be very clear in your mind is that a drug's action is determined by its effects on healthy human beings. A human being is a multifaceted, complex and vital organism. तो एक drug substance का जो effect रहेगा उसके ऊपर ज़रूरी नहीं है कि एक ही plane पर या एक ही level पर effect करेगा. वो different level पर different influences दिखाएगा, right? तो हम लोग क्या सभी level और सभी spheres के action को ले सकते हैं homeopathic treatment के लिए? आपको क्या लगता है? Let me know in the comment section below. Please use the comment section liberally so that I get to know that I have put my point across. Dr. Hughes talks about three types of effects that a drug substance can have on a healthy human being. First, its mechanical effect. Now, drug substances being material substances, if introduced into the body in a material dose, can have certain effects on the body based on its physical properties. For example, swallowing olive oil can help detach biliary calculi or crude mercury to overcome intestinal obstruction. Now, however harmless or effective that these methods seem, they do not come under the sphere of Similia Similibus. Next are the chemical effects. Now, drug substances with chemical properties can exert the same effect in the organism that they have outside. For example, an alkali will neutralize the acid in stomach as much as it would in a test tube. So it's obvious ki homeopathicity ka H bhi nahi hai isme. The third and the last type of drug energy is something that we so dearly call as the dynamic energy. Dynamic energy is called so because it is apparent only in the presence of life. To define it, dynamic energy is the reaction that a drug stimuli can excite in a living matter. So the dynamic energy is manifest as a vital action. Now let me tell you, I am not here to explain the vital principle or dynamic nature of homeopathy. We are just discussing the sixth lecture of the Principles and Practice of Homeopathy by Dr. Richard Hughes, that is Similia Similibus. If you want, we can talk about vital principle and the realm of dynamic later on. Right now, let's focus on what we are talking about. Vital action can be manifest topically, that is, on the skin and mucous membranes. For example, the nitrate of silver or silver nitrate, AgNO3, or arsenic can produce artificial inflammation on the tissues if applied topically. In the same manner, it can also cure topical inflammation because it excites artificial inflammation in the already inflamed tissue, which leads to the cure of the original inflammatory attack. It may seem that the therapeutic law of nature is being applied here, but the effect of other topical agents fail us miserably. For example, arnica would resolve contusions. However, it won't cause contusions if applied on healthy parts. Similarly, calendula wouldn't cause wounds, although it resolves wounds. Also, the fumes of osmium can produce idiopathic eczema. However, it does not cure it. Can you think of any other examples to or against the topical vital action of drugs? Please share with us in the comment section below. Now, Dr. Richard Hughes tells us that the dynamic action of drugs must be exerted on the patient's self, rather than on the guests for whom the patient, against his or her will, is playing the part of a host. That is to say, it mustn't act on the parasites. Of course, parasites are also living matter. So one can debate that the dynamic action can be on the parasite as well. It can be, of course. It is not similar. For example, sulfur ointment cures itch of scabies, not due to the homeopathic action, but because of its dynamic toxic action on the parasite Echinus scabii. Same way, santonin kills roundworms, Felix mask kills the tinea, so on and so forth. So the dynamic toxic action directly on the parasites rather than the host or the patient is not under the realm of similia similibus. Homeopathic action must be for the patient self and not for the parasites. In the similar manner, certain drugs have a special effect on the new growths or adventitious growths. For example, mercury and iodine, that's also not similia similibus. Dynamically acting drugs influencing the living matter, neither parasitic nor adventitious, doing this constitutionally and not merely topically, are called as homeopathic medicines. From the list of such medicines, we reach the remedy based on the rule, let lights be treated by lights. The similarity required here are the pathogenetic effects of the drug and the phenomena of diseases. So dynamic, constitutionally acting medicines mil gaye chalo. ठीक है और उनके effects के record भी है हमारे पास. अब इनको apply कैसे करें? I'll leave you with that question. Let me know your views in the comment section below. Give me a like if you like the content and found the video helpful. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and click on the bell icon to get the recent updates. Also, do not forget to share it with your friends who would like to know more about Husean philosophy. Thank you for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy.